rep love and loyalty. I'm down for the cause. Originator from the old school, down by law. Check me in my casino, dip like a boss. I got the red, blue, and green, and doubles, of course. I'm the plug, I probably sold 100 or more. I got so much slow, I'm about to open a store. I got pieces you ain't ever seen before. I'm probably sitting on 100 G's or more. My story will leave you with this belief for sure.
Life,
but no life, you know.
Happy birthday, yo. Thirstin Howl III.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. I keep
it low down when I get my travel on. Hey, thank you. To my brother, Thirstin Howl III, a.k.a. Vic Low, a.k.a. Gucci, a.k.a. you know, we love you, kid. We do this for you, kid. Thank you for being the general. Inspiring us, keeping us in line, teaching us, you know what I mean? Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Thirstin Howl, G-Sex Soul from the Wall 808 Underground. Got us all loaded out here, baby.
Shoot! Big shout out, birthday shout out to the general. PR 808 Underground Radio. We support, we play. We show video.
This is high. CP93 and the cycle bike.
Yo, big birthday shout out, Big Vic Low. Thirstin, you already know. 12 Grizzly, Orlando, original Bon Monsi. Back to 94 school shit. We out here real heavy.
Doors flagged with tags that you can let me borrow. I'm gonna wear to the club and bring us back tomorrow.
RedRum, shout out to Thirstin. You know what I'm saying? It's all love and loyalty, brother.
Benching, traveling to the guest house. Bed sheets are creased, steamed and stretched out. Polo country, hungry, kayak climb.
Hold on, my bodyguard is here first. All right. Yeah, from the bottom of my heart, like I said, thank you, man. I want to thank my Orlando family and all that big girls, you know, who wanted to put this together for me, and everybody who felt like, you know, they wanted to come out and show some love, man. I'm honored, man, as a motherfucking 53-year-old. You know, 50 to 35 out this motherfucker. Yeah, man, you know, more than anything, man, we keeping this hip-hop culture alive, where ain't nobody old school. We true school, and we do this forever. There's no retiring age and all that, you know what I mean. But like I said, thank you to everybody, my cousin Boo, my cousin Mike, my kids, my daughter, you know what I mean, the whole everybody, man. You know what I mean, Greg? You know, like, I really don't know how to really express myself at this point, because I'm not really a party-throwing motherfucker for myself, you know? This is something everybody else wanted to do, and, you know, sometimes I feel like I'm not worthy of a party and a celebration, but... Nah, but you know what it is? So many people have been passing away. We have to celebrate life more than we celebrated death. You know, so celebrate your motherfucking birthday every chance you get. Celebrate with your family. Tell your friends you love them. Tell your wife you love her. Tell your kids, show that love, man. And, you know, I want to shout out the champ. You know, I grew up with the champ, right? Champ is a bully, man, but yeah, I used to be bigger than the champ before. You know what I mean? Yeah, that's funny, right? I used to be the bully. And this nigga beat me up now, but tonight, our host for the night, he gonna let you know what it is. We definitely want the energy on fire. When you hear that, let's go, champ, what you gonna say?
Let's go, champ!
Talk to the champ, please.
Let's go, champ. What up, y'all? All right, yo, it's my boy, Birthday Bash. We here for my boy. I'm so happy to be here. This is my first time hosting a party. I hosted a birthday bash, so hopefully I do it right for him, but I'm just happy to be here. Like he said, we grew up together in Brownsville, Brooklyn. He was much bigger than me. He was much bigger than me. He used to come to the school, and we used to be shook, because Vic Lowe was the man. He was doing everything. He was advanced. He was wearing all the fly clothes before we was. He was in it all. You know what I'm saying? He was in the streets before we was. He was like, yo, he's the thug, Mr. Thug. You know what I mean? But he's a good dude. We love him. We all of us do. That's why we're here today, y'all. Am I right?
Yeah!
Can I get a Let's Go Champ?
Let's go, champ!
One more time. Can I get a Let's Go Champ?
Let's go, champ!
I'ma go in the back and smoke more joints. We like, yeah. You know what I mean? Let's go, champ!
Let's go, champ!
We're gonna set it off with my man Sensei, right? Sensei, I'm Sensei!
Let's go, champ! Mysterious force is loose somewhere in outer space. The mysteries of creation are there.
Up in the sky?
Up in the sky.
The moon and the planets are there. And new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Right here, right now, throwing up hell.
Oh,
feeling, you know what I mean? And yo, what up, what up? What up, Shabaam? Yo, what up, everybody? This, yo, where you going? Stuff and that shit? It's real, you know what I mean? Peace. I love y'all, man.
Two L's. Yo, like I said, man, these is people I love, man, because for us, the double L's and the love and loyalty is really a real thing. There's no gimmicks to it. There's none of that. I've been rocking with some people since I was 10 years old. They still my friends to today, no matter where life takes us and all that. And that's what we doing here. Shout out to Kiko in the building. Came all the way from motherfucking Colombia to be here. I want to shout out Wordsworth. Came through the rock with a nigga. What's up to my motherfucking brother, Dane? Dane, where you at, Dane, man? Yo, Dane, come here, man. Come here for a second, cuz I gotta tell y'all something, man. Dane ain't rocking yet, but I still gotta bring him up. Brother Lowe. Yeah! This is a quick little story, right? In 1987, I was a motherfucking messenger delivering packages in Manhattan, right? And I remember that's when you walked around with your Walkman and headphones. I only had one tape, Dane to Dane with Fame. I probably worked for 6 months straight with only one tape, making deliveries 8 hours a day. Like, Dane knows I could be his hype man for his show. I know every lyric, every show. Yo, but the biggest thing, right? You know, cause fashion is the motherfucking fifth element, as they say, right? Y'all know that, right? Y'all know that? But that's a lie. Fashion is the first motherfucking element that ever happened. My brother Dane to Dane is one of the biggest icons in hip hop for fashion. He showed the world how to dress, how to get fly, and how to rock them motherfucking Gucci frames before anybody. And let me tell you, I was rocking the Gucci frame, right or wrong, man. I went hard from 85, especially after I heard Dane, man. So I'm so honored that my brother came to rock with me and all my brothers here. You know the champ. I be scared the champ gonna beat me up sometime, yo. He might run this from back in the day, but yo, like I said, I just shot a video in New York called Mental Prince, right? But it's like, I don't feel it's complete unless I do the last verse and the final part of the video here with y'all tonight. Is that cool with y'all?
Yeah, make some noise for yourself, people! Yeah, like I said,
like I said, it ain't my show tonight. I want to see all my people rock tonight. Because, yo, I'm a fan of everybody first. That's what makes me so ill with my shit, because I love everything everybody here do. So, Orlando, Miami, and anybody who came out, thank you. Much love, man. Much love. Make some noise for yourself.
Oh, shit.
Check this out, right? So, I was a teenager. I'm 40 now. I was a teenager in high school. I'm telling y'all my real age, right? I just turned 40. Anyway, I was 17 years old. I was going to my junior prom. And I had the opportunity to open up for my brother Thirstin Howl. The same night as my prom. So, I got in the limo. I left my prom. I opened up for you. And I went back to my prom. You know what I'm saying? So this is my OG right here. I love you, bro. Happy birthday. Give it up for my brother Thirstin Howl. That's a real OG. I love you, bro. Thank you, man. My dog. You heard? And yo, but check it out, man. We're gonna set it up like this. I want everybody in here to live out their dreams and do whatever, man. Whatever you feel you can do, do that shit. Right? So on three, I need y'all to say dream big. One, two, three.
He was fly, he was real. Me and him got along. He was from Brooklyn.
years later, Gucci actually turned out to be Thirstin Howl. Okay? Me and him go back to 1987. It was just me, him, and one other Puerto Rican in a whole house full of the craziest black people in the world. And we were the only three people that didn't take no shit from Puerto Ricans. Right? We was standing up for our race. But we used to watch Video Music Box, and there was this one rapper used to come on, and he had the shark skin suit, he had the valleys on, he had the Kango, and we used to look at each other and say, when we come home, we gonna wear them outfits, right? That's the outfit I wanna wear when I get out of jail. And my wife, who's my witness right here, she came to get me when I got out of jail, and I put my yellow valleys on, I put my yellow silk shirt on in the bathroom, and walked out of there a free man. And just so you know, I've never seen jail ever again. I never got a fucking traffic ticket. I never been nothing. I got no felonies. I work with the mayor. I work with the commissioners. I run a little league for little kids. I raised $250,000 probably by now for the kids in Cimarron. Okay? All right. And that's what lowlife doing now. Okay? It ain't what lowlife did back in the days. It's what lowlife do today. And we work for the community, we represent the kids, and then we give back things like this just so we can have fun all in the same room. You know what I'm saying?
Back!
Here, right?
Yeah!
You vouch for me. But yo, with no further to do, I want to introduce the one and only Dane the motherfucking Dane, the Kango Kid, the Kazam Kid, and he got his Kango on right now.
Let's get it, man. Thank you for the introduction, bro. Thank you, Big Earl. I appreciate your love. Hold up.
Yo, hold up, man. This is the motherfucking legendary Day to Day. Make some noise. If you got fly ever in your life, half of it was because of him. Make some noise. If you ever wore some Gucci frames in your life, it's because of him. Make some noise. Yeah. If you know what a shark skin suit, I know y'all don't know, but make some fucking noise.
Yeah.
And if you know the importance of a Kango hat in hip hop, make some noise.
Yeah.
All right, so y'all know who the fuck Dane to Dane is. Before I give him the mic, y'all better scream y'all lungs out, man, because he came to rock for y'all, to show love, to keep hip-hop alive, to keep the culture alive, to keep spreading it. But this is my brother, somebody I love, and I was a fan before he even fucked with me, so you know how important this is for me to be rocking with Day to Day. Make some fucking noise for that!
Right, he performed
and Dane is coming to town. This is only the second time he ever performed that song, because it was one of my favorite songs of all
time. Alright.
Make some noise for my brother Dane today, please.
We got PD Crack, legendary motherfucker PD Crack in the building.
Ring,
yeah,
ring.
You heard? Listen, brother, real talk, man, I want to hold you because I know you're busy. But what did it mean to you to come out tonight for Thirstin Howl III's birthday?
Hey, check this out, man. I've been a fan of the whole low-life situation since a kid. And especially because I'm from Philly, and that's really a New York-based situation. I was watching it as a fan from afar. So to meet him firsthand and just be around all the lowlifes, as a kid, that's all we rocked. Me, Freeway, Indy 5, polo shirts, collars flipped up. That was a thing, you know what I mean? I'm from that era. So to be around the originators of this situation, man, is a blessing, man. Love, man. So check it out. This is the one and only PD Crack. We live in the building with Check the Rhyme Radio.
Ring. We got Termanology in the motherfucking building.
Yes, sir.
Listen, man, you just killed it. But my question to you, brother, is what did it mean to you to rock tonight for Thirstin Howl III's birthday?
Man, I love Thirstin Howl III, bro. That's a big homie to me. I've been knowing him since a teenager, and he's always been solid with me. Always, you know, been like a big bro. And, you know, a lot of people in the house tonight was my friends. I got to rock. I got to make some new fans. I got to, you know, see some old faces. But at the end of the day, bro, it was lit. Shout out to Diamond D. You know, we made a song today in the studio before we came here. That's legendary. You know, shout out to LeBron James. That's my dog. He be showing mad love. Shot a video with him today, too. So, you know, we just out here working, man. But at the same time, man, we came to celebrate for my brother Vic Lo. You know the vibes, man. Terminology, love is love, man. Check the Rhyme Radio. You know how
it is. Loose, you already know what it is. Favorite Puerto Rican GQ to Ember. See, CTR23, Check the Rhyme Radio. Authentic, never augmented. Man, we got Meyhem Loren in the building, man. What was it like, man? Just, you know, rocking for Thirstin Howl, the third today for his birthday bash.
I mean, it was love. That was the whole reason I'm here. That's my brother. He's one of the most solid people I've met. I learned a lot from him coming up. A lot of people don't know that. A lot of people might not know me and his history. And, like, when I first met Thirst, I wasn't even an artist. Like, I learned a lot being around him and watching his grind and watching his come up. So, being that I had the opportunity to pull up and show some love, like, how could I not, man? What up, man? You got Mayhem Loren. We rocking with Check the Rhyme Radio.
Yeah. Check the Rhyme Radio. Authentic, never augmented. God damn, we got Sydney Poitier, Shabaam, Sahdeeq, and goddamn John Jigg.
Yeah, man.
Wow, y'all the big three in hip hop right now, you know what I'm saying? And I mean that, lyric wise, you heard?
That's the big three.
Look, it's set up the way it's supposed to be. Shabaam, you in the middle, you the point guard, you heard? These are the power forwards right here. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man, you know how I do. Come on, son, I'm an MC too, bro. You know, the wordplay is ill. But, like, what was it? John, I already asked you this question, but you know what? You can still jump in because, you know, you get new thoughts all the time. But what was it like to rock out tonight, especially for Thirstin Howl III? Like, what did that mean to y'all?
Man, it felt good, you know what I mean? Celebrating my brother's life, you know what I mean?
Word. Facts. Sid, I got to ask you the same question, fam. You know what I'm saying?
Well, you know, if you talk to Thirstin Howl, he'll tell you that hip-hop saved his life. You know, the good thing about that is hip-hop saved a lot of our lives.
Facts.
If you know, it catches under pressure. And in them neighborhoods, man, and dudes under pressure, you find something that you're good at and something that you love and you're passionate about, and it gives you a way out. It's a beautiful thing, man. I respect Thirstin Howl, man, because, you know, hip-hop saved his life. Hell, it saved mine. And, you know, I respect that, man. This is something, you don't get this a lot. So I wanted to make sure I was definitely a part of this.
Facts.
You got to keep this thing going another 30 years, you know what I mean?
Yeah, fact. That's a fact.
Low life events and all that fly shit.
It was a great feeling to be able to come out here and do this, man. You know what I mean?
in a room with a bunch of people that really, really appreciate this art form, yeah, what we do, man, this culture. It's a beautiful thing, man. Like the love that's here, man. It's like, this is fellowship. Like I said before, it's fellowship.
Cheers. Salute. You already know this. Favorite Puerto Rican GQ to Ember. CTR 23, check the rhyme radio. Authentic, never augmented. Diamond D in the fucking building.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I know you busy, brother. You know what I'm saying? Doing legendary shit. But I just got one question. What did it mean to you tonight to be here for Thirstin Howl III's birthday? You know what I'm saying?
Well, I mean, it's an honor. You know, me and Thirstin, you know, we go back, low lives and all that. You know, I'm here for that. Also, I came down here, finished working on a song with my man right here, LeBron Shane. Come here, step in the picture real quick.
You know what I mean? The plug right there.
My big brother,
you know, we out here, we making it happen. BITC forever. Yo, what's up? It's your man, Big Diamond D, and I'm right here on Check the Rhyme Radio. Real hip hop in full effect, baby. Let's go.